Hi everyone, today we're discussing identity deception attacks. First, let's explore what identity deception really means. Identity deception happens when an attacker pretends to be the victim. The attacker can execute the attack without the victim's password. This includes MITM middle attacks, replay attacks, and IP spoofing. Now, let's see what a MITM middle attack is. A MITM middle attack occurs when an attacker intercepts communication between two people by installing network devices or eavesdropping tools, and sends data that has been intercepted, altered, or forged. Now, let's check out the diagram below. We have two users, user A and user B. User A and user B are exchanging data over the network. But the attacker is in the middle of user A and user B. For user A, he thinks he's talking to user B. For user B, he thinks he's talking to user A. In fact, in the middle, the attacker intercepts or manipulates the communication between A and B. So, what are the defenses? This means using encrypted communication along with identity verification. Now, let's look at replay attacks. So, what exactly is a replay attack? It's when the attacker first intercepts a valid message, and after a while, sends that message back to the original recipient unchanged. Let's take a look at an example. Imagine the bank president sends an encrypted email signed with his personal digital signature to an employee. Because the email is encrypted, attackers can't access the email's content through password sniffing. Because the email is signed with the bank president's personal digital signature. When the employee gets this email, he knows the email was sent by the president himself. If the email says to wire 10,000 yuan to Zhang Sen, then after Zhang Sen intercepts the email, and he can guess the email's content, what will Zhang Sen do? After a while, Zhang Sen will resend the email unchanged. So, in this situation, after the bank employee receives this email, they will wire 10,000 yuan to Zhang Sen. This is known as a replay attack. So, how can we protect ourselves from replay attacks? The first way is to add a nonce to the message, which is a random number used only once to represent a specific message. But this method has a downside, as the receiver must store all the random numbers they receive, which leads to high storage costs, which means that when the receiver gets a message, he will get the nonce for this message and compare it to all previously stored nonces. If this nonce is new, he will see this message as valid. Otherwise, he will think this message has been replayed. But this method has the downside of needing to store too many nonces. The second method is to add a timestamp to the message. This method is quite simple, but it does have a drawback, because the clocks of computers on the internet can be out of sync, meaning our local computer and a remote one online. The two computers' clocks might not be synchronized. Attaching a timestamp to a message doesn't fully resolve the issue. So, what's the best approach? The best approach is to use both a nonce and a timestamp. Let's assume the maximum timestamp error between internet hosts is delta. Assuming host A's current clock time is T, before the next time interval comes along, host A just needs to store all nonces with timestamps between T delta and T加 delta. In other words, host A only accepts messages with timestamps in this range, and the nonce refers to the first instance of those messages. Now, let's examine IP spoofing. IP spoofing includes TCP hijacking and ARP spoofing. ARP spoofing is also called ARP poisoning, To perform TCP hijacking, you must first understand SYN flood attacks. Let's start by explaining what a SYN flood attack is. A SYN flood attack occurs when an attacker sends numerous SYN packets to the target computer. This prevents the target host from communicating with other computers. The attacker floods the target host with SYN packets. This forces the target host to send ACK packets to the forged IP address in the SYN packets. This forces the target host to send ACK packets to the forged IP address in the SYN packets. Since the IP address in the SYN packets is usually fake, this results in the ACK packets being unreachable. In other words, the victim's host won't receive ACK responses in time. As a result, the SYN packets linger in the target host's TCP buffer. If the target host receives a flood of SYN packets quickly, the target host's TCP buffer will be overwhelmed. This prevents the target host from communicating with other normal computers. This explains how SYN flood attack works. Now that we understand how SYN flood attack works, next, let's explore TCP hijacking. In this scenario, imagine an employee named who is getting ready to log in remotely to the company's host V. This means A's connection to V could be hijacked. Let's examine how this process works. First, A sends a SYN packet to the company's host V to request a remote login. Next, the attacker hijacks this packet. The attacker employs a SYN flood attack against the company's host V. This prevents the company's host V from completing the three-way handshake with user A. In the third step, the attacker uses the correct TCP sequence and ACK numbers, pretending to be the company's host V but using the attacker's own IP address, sends a SYN ACK response packet to user A. After user A receives the SYN ACK packet, he sends an ACK response packet back to the attacker. This completes the TCP three-way handshake between the attacker and user A, establishing a connection. This is the complete process of TCP hijacking. Now, let's look at the reasons for TCP hijacking. TCP hijacking occurs because the TCP protocol relies on TCP sequence numbers. ACK response numbers help identify TCP packets belonging to the SYN connection. The TCP protocol doesn't verify if the actual IP address has been altered. So, to tackle TCP hijacking, all defense measures need to be at the TCP layer to monitor and check if the actual IP address of the SYN connection has changed. For instance, we can use TCP wrapper. Now, let's explore ARP spoofing. The MAC address is the unique physical address of each network card. ARP is a link layer protocol that translates IP addresses to MAC addresses. ARP spoofing replaces the MAC address linked to the victim's IP address with the attacker's chosen MAC address to hijack the victim's communications with others. Understanding ARP spoofing principles. To defend against this attack, we need to monitor and reinforce the IPMAC mapping. This segment covers identity deception attacks. That's all for this topic.